What is going on? I am back at Baker's Narrows Lodge in Athapap Lake here. Athapapuskow. Again, that's the last one I'm probably going to say that in the next 3 days. Today, there is a little bit of a wind that I have, so I'm probably going to hunker down in the Otter for the most part, but then tomorrow looks absolutely beautiful, where we'll do a little bit different style from my other lake trout videos. We're gonna try to do a run and a gun thing. But so today it's dark, it's 6:30 or something like that with just a time change. So it's like literally like 5:30 still. The fish don't even know about the time change yet. So yeah, like I said, dark, going to get going, get out there, get set up, maybe a little bit of B-roll here of the setup. We'll see, not too sure. But other than that, I'll be fishing soon. Laker time, baby, my favorite. Well, as you can tell from the sun rising behind me, that had a couple little things go on. Nothing ever goes super smooth your first morning out, right? But I tell you what, the double sleigh right now, double otter sleigh, ooh, mwah, worked amazing. So you can't tell obviously on the camera, but it is windy right now. I don't even know if my camera is focusing. Can't tell. Yeah, kinda. So yeah, it's windy and it's a little bit nipply. So I am going to probably spend most of the day in the shack, in the heater. And like I said, tomorrow though, hopefully it should be running a gun thing. So I'm going to get set up and get fishing. I'm finally set up and fishing. I'm embarrassed to even tell you what time it is, but I think I've got everything going. Camera rolling there, rolling, underwater camera rolling. Although I don't know if I'm a big fan of where it's points right now. I'm marking a bunch of fish down there too right now. Oh, there's been lots of snow. So yeah, this was a project and a half this morning. Oh, here we go. Small guy. Darty. Tiny. Tiny fish. Tinies. Those aren't the ones I'm looking for. Those are tiny ones. He's come and have a peek, though. Jig's bigger than you are, sunshine. Oh, there's another one from behind. Tiny ones. Tiny ones. Nice fish, nice fish, nice fish. Come on, come on, here we go. Come on. Oh, yes, oh, good fish, good fish. Oh, yes, yes, that is a great way. Oh, baby, it's got me at 52 feet right now and it's going back down. Gotta get down, get the transducer. I've had a slower start to the morning, obviously took me forever to get set up. And then I lost a fish almost instantly. Got a tight drag because I want to get a good hook set. That's a good fish. Okay, Clayton, panic. Oh, almost fell in the hole. Almost fell in the hole. I got to try to get a better camera angle here too. So I'm in my camera cord, of course, already. But that's the way it goes. Wow. Wow. What a start to the trip. What a start. I've got to get this down a bit lower. Oh, how's that? Okay, it's a little bit better. I'll tell you what, this shack is a little bit tight for Lakers. This shack's a little tight. Oh, just peeling. It's got this rod just doubled over. It's a 44 inch lake trout precision rod and this trout is strong. Oh wow, it's heavy. That is a good fish. I don't know how big, because it's always hard to judge on the camera for sure. Yeah, so I love fishing out of this X-over shelter for my walleye and a running and gun. But I think for lake trout, I think I'm gonna go fish the hub style shacks from now on. Just give you a little bit more room with the long rod. I'm gaining on this fish now. It's coming up. It's coming up. Come on. Got a little better camera angle on there now. Oh, come on, baby. That was awesome. That fish, I saw it come in. It looked like it was gonna eat, and then it didn't, but it turned around and come up and smashed it. Anyway, I've got some slush stuff going on now too. Oh. Oh, this fish is gonna be close here. It's gonna be close. I'm not at my leader yet. Oh, where is it? It's head shaking. It's head shaking. Oh, there it is. There it is. I didn't get a great look at it. It looked pretty good though. Looked pretty good though. Looked pretty good. Oh yeah. Oh yeah, it's a nice fish. Nice fish. Come on, baby. Here it comes. Here it comes. Oh yes. Yes. Oh, that's a good fish. Oh, I got that trap. What a way to start off the trip right there. I'm gonna pop the hook right here in the hole. Oh, what a way. Come on, girl. Just a big clean fish. Easy. Easy. Oh, that is a nice fish. Come on, straighten your tail. Oh, that is heavy. That's a good fish. My hands are shaking a bit. That is a heavy, heavy fish. That is a beautiful fish. Oh, it's heavy. It's like a 38 or 39 inch fish, but it is so fat. Like, my arms are shaking. I don't have my measuring board inside, and I don't want to mess around with this fish too long. Oh, come on. Unbelievable. Unbelievable. Wow, she's kicking already. I want to clear some of the slush to see her go, but you know what? We'll just send her home. She gave me what I wanted. She gave me a good fight. It's time to just send her home. My heart's racing. That fish, for being, like I said, 38, 39 inches, was straight chunk. Like, it was so heavy. What a fish. What a fish. Just an ordinary chartreuse tube. Plain Jane with a trailer hook on it with a piece of Cisco meat. What a start to the trip. Unbelievable. So, like I was saying when I was fighting that fish, this shack might be a little bit too small for this. Now, I'm using a 44 inch rod, so you need just a little bit of extra room. Obviously, with all the camera gear, it really kind of limits my space. So if you weren't filming, you probably would be fine. But with having the double 10 hole and, you know, just all this gear, definitely want to bring my hub for the next couple days, just to give myself that little extra room. I just felt really tight and confined. But that's, like I said, that's just for this style of fishing. So, like, in an ideal world, you could have a flip over shelter like this, plus you could have a hub. I think what I need to do in the future is maybe make a video of the pros and the cons from a flip over to the hub to the people that are interested in buying a shelter, and maybe, you know, kind of what you should look for. And then also, you know, it's just some, like I said, pros and cons of each, because they do have them for sure. It's just so much, these are just so much more mobile compared to a hub shelter. But when the hub shelter, it's like the same size of this, but because of where the tub is and stuff like that, it's like basically double the space on the actual floor. So these lake trout precision rods made by Tuned Up are like perfect for fighting the bigger Lakers. It's a glass rod, so you are going to lose some sensitivity, but you don't need sensitivity when you're fishing with 2 ounce tube jigs like this, or a 1 ounce tube jig. You don't need the sensitivity. You need something with a very good backbone that is going to drive that hook home, but also has a very, very good load in it there. So you have basically a moderate action, so it absorbs all of those head shakes. I know I talk about that in a lot of my videos when it comes to like lake trout or stock trout or the Ciscos. Something that's got a softer mouth like that, you need something that's going to absorb head shakes. Lake trout got big, vicious head shakes. The bigger they get, the more vicious their head shakes are. You need something that's going to be able to absorb every single head shake. Glass rods for big Lakers, there's no way you can beat it, hands down. I'll probably fish with an Admiral tomorrow as well when I'm running and gunning, and that's with a little bit smaller spoon on it with a little more sensitivity. But a big 2 ounce jig like this, you don't need sensitivity. You need something with a very good solid backbone. That's my story. There is lots going on down there right now. Okay, let's try this. I don't know how well I'm going to mark it on the camera because it's probably going to dart around a little bit, but we're going to try it since I've got so much going on right now. It's a little bit lighter rod, a little bit lighter set up here. So if I hook into a great big lake trout, I could be definitely in for a hurting. Jeez, that's a nice fish. Some really nice fish down there right now. I started earlier in the day with mostly smaller fish, but now lots of nicer fish. There's, oh, look at that. Instant. As soon as I got that spoon down there, like instant. It hit it as it was falling, come over and just crushed it. I had that tube jig down there and it literally like probably, I don't even know how long I had it down there for, and the fish, four of them would just circle and circle and circle. And finally, I was like, you know what? I'm gonna change up my baits. And sure as heck. Oh, it's a little bit, I gotta go. Oh, this fish is just fighting hard. So squirrely. Like I said, it's a little bit lighter setup. I'll talk more about it here in a little bit, but this is a nice fish. Nice fish. Nice fish. Nice fish. Oh, yeah. Shh. Okay. Well, that was awesome. That was instant. I was like, I just literally stepped outside, grab some new lures, and like instant, that fish crushed it right as it was falling down. Took it right in the meat of the jaw. Super Leach flutter spoon. Get him untangled. Quick show off. Nice fish. Not a slob, but very, very respectable fish. Back down you go. Okay. Shagom. So that's what I'm using there. Super Leach flutter spoon. It's the biggest size. I believe it's actually a 3/8 ounce. It feels way heavier though. It's pretty dense. Tipped with the little Cisco belly, but that lure had a total water time so far of 10 seconds. So this, got my camera set up again. This is a little bit different setup. This is a 38 inch Admiral. It's made for big walleyes or like good size Lakers. I don't know if I'd really want to catch a 45 inch Laker on this rod. It would probably take me for a run for sure. But it definitely handled that fish quite well. It's got 15 pound braid on it, the ice line from Power Pro. It's a little bit light for what I'd like. But yeah, I just had to try something different. Been using those, the lake trout rods, which I talked about earlier, the lake trout precision, those glass rods, where they don't have the sensitivity, but they have the backbone. So we'll see what happens here. We'll see if one of these fish are going to make me a believer, maybe downsizing a little bit, because that one sure did. That was like instant. As it was falling, that fish just come over and just crushed it. Got like four fish down there right now. Here it comes. Got him. Got him. That fish just flew in there. Absolutely flew in there. That was insane. Wow. Wow. So I think right now, like, the ultimate thing would obviously be have two rods going. One where I can have a little bit bigger bait for some of the bigger fish. And then this so I can catch some nice trout like this. Like I said, I'm scared to catch a 45 incher on here. Although I could probably make it happen. This fish, this rod is definitely perfect for these size of lake trout. Look at that. These fish are strong. Man, lake trout are the ultimate when it comes to ice fishing. Like, the ultimate. Here it comes. Here it comes. Here it comes. Not big. Here it comes. Oh, chikai. Oh, chikai. Okay. A little bit darker, like I said. Look at that. I don't know if you can see that. Look at that. Lake trout do have teeth. Razor sharp teeth. You don't want to put your fingers inside of a lake trout. Well, that was cool. That was cool. Okay, let's see if you can go down without making a mess there. Okay, perfect. Not too much of a mess. Wow, this little spoon is two for two. Did not take long. So this wasn't the planned topic for today at all, but obviously I've been talking lots about the rod so far. And now that I am using something a little bit different, before, like I said, I was using that lake trout precision rod, and that was that glass rod where you give a little bit of your sensitivity for that power and then that action of the rod where it absorbs all those head shakes. This rod is a little bit different where it's got a pile of feel. This is a graphite rod, so, or composite, I guess they could say composite graphite, something like that, where it has a pile of sensitivity in it. And I could go like this and I could shut my eyes and I'll feel every single little thing on it. Even if I'd go to a smaller spoon, you can just feel everything, especially with that braided line and no stretch. It just gives you that, it gives you such a feedback, an instant feedback, where, like I said, is the glass rod, you don't get that feedback, but you don't need it for those, the bigger jigs. But when I downsize a little bit, that's why I'm using this Admiral. And like I said, it's got a 15 pound Power Pro ice line on it. I think that's the highest you can get. I'd like to go to a 20, but then I have a 20 pound fluorocarbon leader. And like I showed you the teeth on those lake trout, if you go too small, you can cut like a fluorocarbon leader up, like say like a, you know, a 10 or 8 pound fluorocarbon leader, you will probably bust that line. Whereas something just a little bit thicker, you're not going to bust them on the lake trout. Every lake trout's different too. That one, like in particular, that smaller one there had like razor sharp teeth all along, where if that line ran across its bottom jaw, you could easily slice your line in half. Oh, look at this fish. Come on. Come on. Here we go. Fish is lining me up. Here he comes. Here he comes. Oh, he stopped. Why did he stop? Not a bad fish. Here he comes. Come on. He likes it. He likes it. He likes it. He's gonna eat it. He's gonna eat it. Come on. Here we go. Got him. That took a little bit, but we coaxed him into eating. You could tell he wanted to eat it. He took a couple passes at it, just didn't commit. I'm having way more success with this tiny spoon today than I am the bigger jig. But obviously the fish are smaller though too, right? Like, it's harder to catch the smaller fish on the big tackle. If you're gonna commit yourself to fishing with like a 6-inch tube like that, you're in a sense kind of committing yourself to kind of, you know, just fish for some big fish. Whereas if you want some action at some point, switching to a spoon, something with a little bit of flash, isn't a bad idea at all. Let's see if we can get you up there. Here she comes. There it comes. Okay. 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 Shh. Just let it burp out, and then I'm going to pick it up right there. Okay, you can see that leech flutter spin right in the corner of its mouth there. It took a while for it to eat, but it did. We got it. Okay, hooks out. Like I said, nice fish. No jumbo, not compared to that monster we caught earlier in the day, but these fish are fun. You know, a nice, like probably 27, 28 inches, something like that. Beauty fish. Yeah, maybe only 25 inches even. Either way, it's a nice fish. Okay. She gone. Like I was saying when I was fighting that fish, it's like, if you know, there's nothing wrong with fishing a big tube jig all day. I've done it lots and I'm going to do it in the future again too. You're definitely changing how many fish you're going to catch in a day. If you fish a spoon like this small all day, you're probably going to put 4 or 5 times the number of fish on the ice than you would with like a 5 or 6 inch tube. But that being said, you're probably going to put more quality fish on the ice if you fish that tube that big of a tube jig. There's going to be days you're going to go out and everything's going to bite that tube jig too, right? Like, I'm not saying that that's the only way you're going to catch a bunch of numbers. It's a downsize. If fish are more aggressive, obviously they're going to eat those bigger baits. But if they're a little bit more neutral to negative, the smaller the bait, the better chance of getting them to actually eat. Oh, yeah. Come on. Oh, good fish. Just didn't eat it. Took a little bite at it. Here comes, coming back. Nice fish. Come on. Eating chum off the bottom. No. That's a nice fish. Come on. I'm gonna eat the jig right off the bottom. Come on. Suck it up. Turn and suck it up. Here we go. Yes. 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 I got it to eat the jig right off the bottom. I saw it eat a piece of chum off the bottom. So I dropped my jig all the way down and it turned to it, raised its tail, and clobbered it. Yes. That's a good fish. That's a good fish. Oh, it's got some weight. Oh, Clayton. Oh, just settle down, Clayton. Don't panic. Let's do this. Heater off. Check. Let's get down, get that transducer now. Oh, she wants to run. Oh, she's got me just doubled right over. Oh, I thought I'd come off. But I just took a charge up at me. She's coming right up. Now she's coming up. Okay, let's get that transducer. Check. Transducer, good. We got her. We don't have her yet. But come on. This is a great way to end the day right now. Start off with a big fish and end with a nice fish. It's not as big as the one from this morning, but it's a nice mid 30 inch fish. Come on. She's on the bottom of the hole. Come on. Don't fight it. There she comes. Oh, yeah. Oh, come on, girl. Oh, yeah. Those double tails. Come on. We got her. Yes. What a way. Oh, to possibly cap off my day right here. Unbelievable. Beautiful fish, like a 35 inch or something like that. Maybe 36. I don't know. It's beauty. What a great way to end my day and get, oh, I can't even think right now, man. That was barely hooked. Oh, what a beauty fish. What a great way to end my day and get some momentum going into tomorrow. I caught a pile of nice fish today, plus these two good fish. This one's, like I said, 35, maybe 36 inches, and that nice big one this morning. But like always, I just want to take care of these fish more than anything. What a beautiful fish. Beautiful fish. Oh, that was so cool. That fish I messed with probably, I don't know, 30 to seconds to 45 seconds, maybe in a minute, kept circling me. I watched it eat a piece of chum off the bottom. So like, you know what, I'm gonna wait till it kind of sees my jig. I'm just gonna slow drop it to the bottom. So I did that. As soon as it turned and I know it could see my jig, I just slow dropped it to the bottom and just let it sit there. And that trout come from behind it, raised its tail and slurped it in. It doesn't get any better than that. Unbelievable. So like I said, I'm staying up at Baker's Narrows here on Athapap Lake. I'll leave all of the numbers here and everything in the description below. But this trip's kind of fun for me because this is literally about a year to the date where I had a heartbreak moment last year. And then I had some redemption the second day. And then I actually caught a really nice fish on the last day too. So this is literally like a year ago from today that I had all of that happen. So, and if you like this lake trout fishing, you're gonna wanna watch the videos from last year too. If you haven't yet, I'll leave them in the link in the description below. There'll be a link to all those videos down there. So yeah, that'll probably wrap up my first day here. Hopefully tomorrow's gonna be something a little bit different. If the weather holds to what they're saying, where there's gonna be really low winds and like 0 degrees, -2, something like that, I'm gonna try to fish outside all day and do some running and gunning instead of just sitting on one spot. So yeah, thanks for watching guys, and as always, get outside.